Chapter 29, Chennai's Bhajani Mela. It was in the year 1916 when a Chennai's Bhajani Mela party of the Ramdasi Pant started on a pilgrimage to the holy city of Benares. The party consisted of a man, his wife, a daughter and sister-in-law. Unfortunately, their names are not mentioned. On their way, the party heard that there lived in Shirdi, Ahmednagar district, a great saint named Sai Baba, who was God-realized and who was very generous and distributed money every day to his bhaktas and to skillful persons who went and showed their talent there. A lot of money in the form of dakshina was collected daily by Sai Baba, and out of this amount he gave daily 1 rupee to a 3-year-old girl, Amani, the daughter of a bhakta Kondaji, and rupees 2 to 5 to some, rupees 6 to Jamali, the mother of Amani, and rupees 10 to 20 or even rupees 50 to other bhaktas as he pleased. On hearing all this, the party came to Shirdi and stayed there. The Mela did very good bhajan and sang very good songs, but inwardly they desired money. Three of the party were full of avarice, but the lady or the mistress was a very different nature. She had regard and love for Baba. Once it so happened that when the noon arti was going on, Baba was much pleased with her faith and devotion and gave her vision of her Ishta deity. To her, Baba appeared as Sitanath, Ram, while to all others it was usual Sainath. On seeing her beloved deity, she was very much moved. Tears began to flow from her eyes and she clapped her hands in joy. The people began to wonder at her joyful mood, but they were not able to guess its cause. Late in the afternoon, she disclosed everything to her husband. She told him how she saw Sri Ram in Sai Baba. He thought that she was a very simple and devout woman, and her seeing Ram might be a creation of her mind. He ignored her, saying that it was not possible that she alone could see Ram, but they all saw Sai Baba there. She did not resent this remark, as she was fortunate enough to get Ram Darshan, and when her mind was calm and composed and free from avarice. Wonderful vision. Things were going on like this when the husband got a strange vision in his dream one night. He was in a big city. The police there had arrested him and tied his hands with rope and put him in a cage lockup. As the police were tightening the grip, he saw Sai Baba standing quiet outside near the cage. On seeing Baba so close, he said in a plaintive tone, "After hearing your fame, I restored to your feet. Then why should a calamity befall me when you are standing here in person?" Baba said, "You must suffer the consequences of your action," he said. "I have not done anything in this life which would bring such a misfortune to me." Baba said, "If not in this life, you must have committed some in your past life." He replied, "I do not know anything of my past life, but assuming that I did commit some sin then, why should it not be burnt and destroyed in your presence, as happens to dry grass before fire?" Baba, "Have you got such faith?" He, "Yes." Baba then asked him to close his eyes. No sooner did he shut them than he heard a thumping sound of something falling down, and after opening his eyes, he saw that he was free and the police had fallen down bleeding. Being much frightened, he began to look at Baba, who said, "Now you are well caught. Officers will now come and arrest you." Then he begged, "There is no other savior except you. Save me anyhow." Then Baba again asked him to close his eyes. He said so, and when he opened them, again he saw that he was free, out of the cage, and that Baba was by his side. He then fell to Baba's feet. Baba then asked him, "Is there any difference between this namaskar and your previous ones? Think well and then reply." He said, "There's a lot of difference. My former namaskars were offered with the object of getting money from you, but the present namaskar is the one offered to you as God. Besides, earlier I thought resentfully that you, being a Mohammedan, were spoiling the Hindus." Baba, "Do you not believe in your mind in Mohammedan gods?" He said, "No." Then Baba said, "Have you not got a panja in your house, and do you not worship the same in Tabut, that is Muharram festival? Also, there is in your house another deity by name Kadbibi, whom you propitiate and appease on marriage occasion and other festivals. Is it not so? He admitted all this. Then Baba said, what more do you want? Then a desire arose in his mind to get the darshan of his Guru Ramdas. When Baba asked him to turn back and see, and when he turned around, lo, Ramdas was in front of him. No sooner did he bend to fall on his at his feet, Guru Ramdas vanished. Then he inquisitively asked Baba, you look old. Do you know your age, Baba? What do you say? I am old. Just race with me and see. On saying this, Baba began to run and he too followed. Baba disappeared in the dust raised by his footsteps while running, and at that moment, man was awakened. After waking up, he began to think seriously about the dream vision. His mental attitude was completely changed and he realized the greatness of Baba. After this, his doubting tendencies disappeared and pure devotion to Baba's feet descended on his mind. The vision was a mere dream, but the questions and answers therein were most significant and interesting. Next morning, when all assembled in the masjid for aarti, Baba gave him as prasad 2 rupees worth of sweetmeats and also 2 rupees from his pocket and blessed him. He made him stay there for a few more days and gave him his blessing, saying, Allah will give you plenty and he will do you all good. He did not get more money, but he got far better things, that is Baba's blessings, which stood him in good stead all time. The party got plenty of money afterwards and their pilgrimage was successful, as they did not suffer any trouble or inconvenience during their journey. They all returned home safe, thinking of Baba's words and blessings and the anand they experienced by the grace. This story illustrates one of the methods which Baba followed in some cases to improve and reform his devotees. Number 2, Tendulkar family. They lived in Bandra, a suburb in Mumbai, a Tendulkar family, all the members of which were devoted to Baba. Mrs. Savitribai Tendulkar has published a Marathi book named Sri Sainath Bhajan Mala, containing 800 Abhangas and Padas, describing the Leelas of Baba. It's a book worth reading by those who are interested in Baba. The son, Babu Tendulkar, was studying hard day and night and wanted to appear for the medical examination. He consulted some astrologers. On examining his horoscope, they told him that the stars were not favorable that year and that he should appear for the examination next year, when he would be certainly successful. This cast a gloom over him and made him restless. A few days afterwards, his mother went to Shirdi and saw Baba. Amongst other things, she mentioned the gloomy and morose condition of her son, who was to appear for the examination in a few days. On hearing this, Baba said to her, tell your son to believe me, so to throw aside horoscopes and predictions of astrologers and palmists and go on with his studies. Let him appear for the examinations with calm mind. He is sure to pass this year. Ask him to trust me and not to get disappointed. The mother returned home and communicated Baba's message to her son. Then he studied hard and in due course appeared for the examination. In the written papers he did well, but being overtaken by doubts, he thought that he would not secure sufficient marks for passing. So he did not care to appear for the oral examination, but the examiner was after him. He sent word through a fellow student stating that he had passed in the written examination and that he should appear for the oral. The son, being thus encouraged, appeared for the oral examination and was successful in it also. Thus he got through the examination that year successfully by Baba's grace. Though the stars were against him, as indicated, it is to be noted that here that doubts, the difficulties surround us just to move us and confirm our faith. We are tested, as it were, if we only hold on steadily to Baba with full faith and continue our endeavors, our efforts will be ultimately crowned with success. The father of this boy, Raghunath Rao, was serving in some foreign mercantile firm in Mumbai. As he grew old, he was not able to attend his work properly, and so he had to take leave and rest. As he did not improve during the period of leave, a further extension of leave or premature retirement from service was inevitable. The chief manager of the firm decided to retire him on pension, as he was an old and a reliable servant. The question regarding the amount of pension to be given was under consideration. He was getting rupees 150 per month and his pension, that is half the amount, that is rupees 75, would not be enough to meet the expenses of the family. So they were all anxious about this matter. 15 days before the final settlement, Baba appeared to Mrs. Tendulkar in her dream and said, "I wish that rupees 100 should be settled as pension. Will this satisfy you?" She replied, "Baba, why ask me this? We fully trust in you." Though Baba said rupees 100, still he was given rupees 10 more, that is rupees 110 as a special case. Such wonderful love and care did Baba exhibit towards his bhakta. Captain Harte. Captain Harte, who was studying in Bikaner, was a great devotee of Baba. Once Baba appeared to him in his dream and said, "Did you forget me?" Harte then immediately held Baba's feet and replied, "If a child forgets his mother, how could he be saved?" Then Harte went into the garden and took out a fresh walpapadi vegetables, and after arranging Sita and Dakshina, was about to offer all this to Baba when he was awakened and came to know that the whole thing was a dream. Then he decided to send all this to Baba to Shirdi. When he came to Gwalior some days afterwards, he sent rupees 12 by money order to a friend with instructions that rupees 2 should be spent on buying Shida articles and walpapadi vegetables, and those should be offered to Baba with rupees 10 as Dakshina. The friend went to Shirdi and purchased the things mentioned, but walpapadi was not available. In a short time, a woman turned up with a basket on her head, which curiously enough contained the walpapadi vegetables. It was purchased, and then all things were offered to Baba on behalf of Captain Harte. Mr. Nimonkar prepared the naivedya, rice and walpapadi vegetables, next day and offered the same to Baba. All the people were surprised to see that Baba, while dining, took and ate walpapadi and did not touch rice and other things. Harte's joy knew no bounds when he learned this from his friend. Consecrated rupee. At another time, Captain Harte wished that he should have in his house a rupee consecrated by Baba with his touch. He came across a friend who was bound for Shirdi. Through him, Harte sent his rupee. The friend went to Shirdi and, after the usual salutation, gave first his dakshina, which Baba accepted. Then he gave Harte's rupee, which Baba took in his hand and began to gaze at it. He held it in his front, tossed it up and up with his right thumb and played with it. Then he said to his friend, "Return this to its owner with the prasad of Udi. Tell him that I want nothing from him. Ask him to live in peace and contentment." The friend returned to Gwalior, handed over the consecrated rupee to Harte and told him all that had happened in Shirdi. This time, Harte was much pleased and realized that Baba was always encouraged good thoughts, and as he wished intently, Baba fulfilled the same accordingly. 4. Vaman Narvekar. Now let the readers hear a different story. A gentleman named Vaman Narvekar loved Baba very much. He once brought a rupee. On one side of it were engraved the figures of Ram, Lakshman and Sita, and on the other side was engraved the figure of Maruti with folded hands. He offered it to Baba with the hope that he should consecrate it with his touch and return it to him with Udi. But Baba immediately pocketed it. Then Shama spoke to Baba regarding Vaman Rao's intention and requested him to return it. Then Baba spoke to him in the presence of Vaman Rao, "Why should it be returned to him? We should keep it ourselves. If he gives rupees 10, 25 for it, it will be returned." Then for the sake of that rupee, Vaman Rao collected rupees 25 and placed them before Baba. Then Baba said, "The value of that rupee far exceeds rupees 25. Shama, take this rupee. Let us have it in our store. Keep this in your shrine and worship it." No one had the courage to ask Baba why he followed this peculiar action. He only knows what is best and most suitable to each and all. Bow to Shri Sai. Peace be to all.